Hey everybody, welcome to another Paint the Edge Up. We're teaching to make a cool painting in about an hour and get a little drunk doing it. My name is Joel and I'll be walking you through step by step how to make a painting. Today we are painting this right here called Sunset, Arkansas. Okay, so this is a cool one. You can make a nice little sunset scene and you can put whatever state you want or whatever symbol you want. If you like a star shape or whatever you want, you can do whatever symbol you want. I picked Arkansas because it's, you know, just, I don't know, I live in Arkansas, whatever, just something. So, before I tell you what you need for this painting, please search Paint the Edge Off, like, share, follow, subscribe, all that stuff. Like always with all my painting classes, I'm going to give away a free giveaway painting. All you have to do is correctly answer my subjective trivia question first in the comments, and I will send you a free painting of your choice. I also have shot glass. I forgot to get my shot, so I'm drinking one of these. I also have shot glasses. I don't know if you can even see it that well, but says Paint the Edge Off, pretty nice. It's real nice. So anyway, I got those. If you want one, let me know. I can send you one. Okay. What you're gonna need for this painting today is a 16 by 20 canvas or some kind of canvas. That's what I'm using, a 16 by 20. But you can use whatever size you want. I've got an easel. Okay, something to sit my painting on. You can lay it down flat if you want, but I've got an easel. I've also got paper towels. Okay, I've got a water cup. You need some kind of water cup to mix your acrylic paint in with. Water's kind of the medium for that. Paper plates for my palette. I've got a blow dryer. Helps me dry my painting nice and fast. I've got whiskey. Excuse me. And I've got some tools here, okay? So I've got some chalk. I got some orange and some blue chalk. I've also got a pencil. I've got a Sharpie. And I've got my four brushes. I also have a kneaded eraser in case I need to erase anything I draw. And I've got my four brushes. I got my big flat brush, my medium flat brush, my medium round brush, and my little baby round brush, okay? So anytime you're not using those, put them in the bristle down your water cup. And yeah, I think that's everything. So, paint colors. Black, white, phthalo blue, violet, purple, light yellow, and a bright red. Okay, so those are all my paint colors. All right, so with that, let's take a shot and get going, okay? Okay, cheers. Paint the edge off, everybody. Okay. Shot counter. Uno. Okay, what am I doing? Okay, so what we're gonna do first here is we're gonna start by drawing a little horizon line. So let's take our pencil, handy dandy pencil, and let's make a line across that's just a little below halfway. If I find about halfway, let's just drop it down a little bit and make yourself a nice little horizon line there, okay? Boom, horizon line. Okay, and that's all the drawing we're doing, so maybe one more shot. Okay, I gotta remember to do this one. I think I start with the sky. It's your typical sunset. Start with your kind of yellows, then go to your orange, your blues and purples, and just kind of blend them in as you go. Okay. Okay, sorry, I'm not very focused today. I had a bunch of stuff going on, right? But then I barely got in here on time. Okay, so let's take some yellow, some red and some blue, and we'll get a little bit of purple too while we're at it. Go ahead and get all our colors on here, and we'll get a little bit of white. But let's start with our primary colors and purple and white. So most of our colors, honestly, all of our colors except for black on here. There we go. Got a nice plate of paint. Let's take our big brush out, tap it off, give it a nice little taparoo, and let's start here right with our horizon line with some yellow, and we'll work our way up into orange. Okay, so I'm gonna take just some yellow by itself. I'm not even gonna really mix much white in with this background. Maybe a little bit, but I'm gonna try it just plain old yellow. Okay. Go take that across. Now, I know, now as I'm painting this, I know I'm gonna kind of paint around, paint this black over everything. So I know on the outside edges, I'll cover stuff up, but I would kind of treat it as if you don't know you're gonna do that, because you'll try to cut it too close, and then lo and behold, you'll paint something that's like, oh crap, I didn't paint my paint all the way out there, now there's kind of this, like, spot that's... So I'm gonna go pretty much all the way to the edges. I mean, I'm gonna go maybe touch every single edge, but I'm gonna go pretty far. I'm gonna go far, okay? I'm gonna go pretty far. Let's take a little bit of red and mix up a little orange here. Just a little bit of red with a whole big pile of orange. Maybe I'll see you. And there we go. Let's take that right above that yellow. So right now I've just kind of got these two layers next to each other. I'm just gonna kind of leave that little spot. Now I'm gonna go down, just keep brushing. Okay, just left, right. Work your way down. All right. And then let's just bring it back up. Boom. There you go. Look at that. All right, let's take some red. Get a little bit of red on your paintbrush. And let's make just a little strip of this. Just a little strip right there. And again, we'll do the same thing. We'll kind of paint that down into the orange. Bring the orange up into the red, bring the red down to the orange, etc., etc. Okay, there we go, there's that. Now what we want to do is we're going to take some blue. Okay, this is what's going to be tricky. The blue and the red meat, when they meet, it's going to be as a dark color. I might use a little bit of purple in there just to kind of maybe help mix it, but I'm going to start with just some blue. Little touch of white, just a tiny bit of white. Mix it with my blue, just a barely, just so it's just noticeable. It's just a touch lighter than the just regular phthalo blue. Phthalo blue is super dark by itself, so a little bit of white's not, still not going to make it super light. It's still going to be kind of light. Okay, but there we go. There's a good color to start with. And yeah, so there you go. We got sky color. Again, I'm going to go all the way to my side edges, even though I know I'm gonna probably paint a lot of it black, but I don't care. Okay, I don't care. You can't make me care. There we go. Okay, now I've gotten to where the red is. Okay, let's do this. Let's take our brush, wash it a little bit. Just give it a little wash. Not totally clean or anything. Just give it a little wash there. Just give it a little rinse, little spritz there. A little rinse dry. Now I'm gonna take some purple. Now let's take a little bit of purple in here, just to kind of... Oh, yeah, there we friggin' go. Okay, now let's take that and kind of blend that. Okay, I'm gonna... You know what, if I pull this way for some reason, the red seems to be kind of mixing there a little better. That's okay. Okay, let's just get this all mixed in. I'm gonna take a little bit of red and purple on my brush and kind of maybe make some streaks in here like so. Let's just take some more red. Okay, let's just do that. Let's just get more red. See, now what's happening is my orange and my blue and purple are gonna mix. It's not gonna look pretty. So I'm gonna go ahead and wash my brush out. This is that delicate spot where, you know, your sky gets real dark. It happens. There's easy ways to fix it. First of all, wash all the paint out of your brush. Get it clean. Wipe it off, dry it off really good. And then I'm gonna go in and just lightly brush. Blend that, soften that edge up. Okay, that's blending a lot better. And it's not quite as dark as it looks on the camera. Right on the camera, it almost looks black, but really not. Well, that doesn't make it look any better. Anyway, but when this, I'm gonna give this a second. When it dries, we'll take some more reds and yellows in there and kind of, you know, we'll kind of fix that. We'll fix it up. Okay, so sky done, shot. And, yeah. Let's see. Yeah, so that's... We want to lighten that up. Look, can you see it says paint the edge off? Can you see it? You can't really see it. It's like out of focus. Oh, you can kind of see it there. Wait, what am I doing? Whatever, it says paint the edge off. I think it's cool. God, it's so hot in here. This room's not really heated or aired. It just kind of feeds off the rest of the house. It doesn't really get as cold as the rest of the house. And so whatever temperature it is outside tends to affect this room a lot. It's pretty hot outside. Okay, let's start down here in the water. What I want to do down here is take yellow and make a little yellow kind of, you know, a little yellow, you know, area, section down the middle. And then I'm going to take a little bit of blue on the outsides. And then I'll come back later and we'll add all these other colors. But for now, we're just going to kind of do the yellow and the blue. I'm going to wash my brush. Oh, boy. Okay. Let's see. What's been going on? What has been going on? Not much. It's summertime in Fayetteville, which means everyone's kind of out of the town. Okay, now for this, when I take yellow here, I'm going to get a little bit of white. Mix some white in with your yellow. And kind of a lot yellow. Oh, God, sorry. Okay, got my light yellow. And, let's just start down here right through the middle. Let's see. Is this the middle? Where's the middle? There. That should be the middle. Okay. And I'm just going to turn my brush on that skinny side. And I'm going to go all the way up to that horizon line. Excuse me. And I'm going to take this down. Maybe you better just kind of start like that. Boom. Don't have to worry about getting everything. And then go back and kind of add those outsides. Honestly, you didn't really need to do this. You can kind of just make just a wide streak there. We'll come back and add this little texture later, I guess, really, when I'm thinking about it. Wash my brush out a little bit. Get some of that same blue color I used up here. I can add a little bit more white, I suppose. Why not? And then we're going to start out here in the edges. We're going to kind of bring this in from the outside. So I'll start here and just get these edges, these spots nice and blocked in. Then I'll bring them in and I'll kind of just, I can let them mix a little bit. I'm just going to kind of let them stop where the yellow is. This is just the first step, is blocking in your colors, okay? It's called blocking in your colors. Once we get the big areas blocked in, and go back in and fancy them up. Okay, so here we go. Now we got this. Let's go ahead and take this into the yellow. Let these colors mix a little bit. Just let them touch, okay? Just want to cover the white of your canvas. We're going to go back and add some more colors on top of this to make them look a little better. But for now, we just want to get these colors in here. I'm trying to not go too far into the yellow. Just let it get right up to the edge, mix a little bit. And we'll call that good. I can dip my brush in a little bit of water, maybe dab it off a little bit so it's not dripping wet. Have it a little bit wetter, and that will probably help some of this rough texture in here. Or maybe it won't. Okay. Whatever. No. Oh. Okay, let's see. There's that. Okay, so it's a lot further to the left than the right. We'll fix that later. Okay, let's blow dry and take a shot and keep moving. Okay, there we go. So that's step phase one. We've got our canvas colored, blocked in. Got the big spots blocked in. And next we'll go back, add some details to the sky and the water. We'll be good. Okay. Let's see. So I'm doing the Arkansas shape here. So my trivia question today relates to Arkansas. And today's trivia question is, if you want to win a free painting, what is Arkansas's main export? Okay, is it A, tobacco, B, Clinton's, C, squirrels. D, Arkansas doesn't export anything. E, tornadoes. F, moonshine. G, sadness. Or H, books. Okay? Give it a guess. Whoever's right, I will mail a free painting to you. How did I think this was the middle? And then it's so far not the middle. It's so far off. There's a fly in here. Okay, take the trivia question down. Take another shot. Okay, Ruth says B, Clinton's. Good guess. Okay. All right, let's get back up here into our sky. Now, I'm going to keep using my big flat brush. If you want to use your medium flat brush, hey, it's a free country, okay? You do whatever. It's a free country. You can do whatever you want unless it's something you can't do. Okay, let's take some yellow. I'm going to get some more yellow. I'm running out. It's a free country. You have the freedom to do the few things you can do, just like every other country. It makes us different somehow. Alright, let's get some yellow, and let's put some streaks in our sky. Let's put some yellow streaks in our sky. Ooh, that looks nice. Sound effects help. That's what I learned in college, was they're always like, you know, it's a decent painting, but your sound effect game is just not good. Get them sound effects going. You're going to do a lot better than I always thought. You're right. Haven't been working on my sound effects. Okay, so there we go. Got some yellow streaks in there. There we go. I'm going to go ahead and wipe my brush off a little bit. I'm going to wash it out too, but I'm just going to start by wiping some of this off. Wash it. Lots of paper towels right now, because my brush is super dirty. Let's get some red paint. I'm not really going to mix anything, just going to get red paint by itself. What you know. And let's really put some red streaks in here. Now the idea is kind of take this red through the dark area up into the blue, so kind of, you know, mitigates, doesn't make it look so dark. Makes the dark part weaker. Makes it not the main. Try to make this lighten up the dark area, right? Okay, and let's put some of this through here as well. Take this some down in here. Nothing really too fancy or planned out there, just kind of freaking that in, okay. Some of this up here is good. Maybe kind of let it fade off. I can also take a little bit of purple. Now the purple, I'm not really going to mix much white in either. I don't think I'll mix any. We'll see. If it's super dark, I can mix a little touch of white in there with it, but let's just start with just plain purple here and see what happens. Ooh, yeah. Ooh. No one wants to. Ooh, okay. Oh, okay. It's not going to show up on the camera quite as much as it is on my painting, but it does look a lot better with that purple. I'm kind of just painting over some of these dark areas there with that purple. And yeah, you know, it's a little better, I guess. What you know. What you know is that you don't know everything. Okay. Something like that. Okay, now. Again, we're going to let this dry a little bit. We'll come back and we'll put our clouds in there. But for now, let's move on. Let's go back down to the water and we'll put some more yellow down there. Get out of here, fly! Stupid fly. Sorry you had to see me like that. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna take my chalk and I'm gonna go, okay, this is how far it is over here. that's about where my yellow needs to go to on this side to make it more even. So here's what I'm going to start doing. I'm going to go ahead and switch to my medium flat brush and get some white and yellow here and start painting. Now, what I want to do is just start kind of manipulating this bottom section here and just start building it up with brush strokes. We're going to alternate colors here. I'm going to start with my yellows. First thing I want to do is kind of bring this all the way over, make sure I'm taking this over to this point, right? I'll go ahead and just paint that in. And it's not going to cover very well. I'm trying to do like 5,000 layers here to make it. Oh no, there we go. That's a little better, I guess. I'm going to go ahead and dry this since let's mess up that edge a little bit. Okay, whatever. This still looks like crap, I know, but that's okay. Yeah. Okay. So I can still see the blue in there. I don't care. I do care, actually. You know what? I do care. I say I don't care, but I really do care. Care too much. What's Arkansas's main export? Is it A, tobacco, B, Clintons, which has already been guessed, C, squirrels, D, Arkansas doesn't export anything, E, tornadoes, F, moonshine, G, sadness, or H, books? All right, give it a guess. The answer may surprise you. Oh my god, it's so hot in here. Tune into painting while I complain. Ugh. It's so hot. Today I'm painting while complaining. Complaining while I paint. Painting while I complain? Okay, let's take our chalk and let's draw some clouds in, and let's take down a trivia question. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is draw in like 3, 4, 5 clouds, something like that. Now, it could be a good idea to go ahead and draw in your state shapes, or something, that's too high, wait, there we go, maybe something like that. Wiggle. Whatever state you're doing, whatever symbol you're doing, might be a good time now to go ahead and draw that in. So you kind of are starting to get an idea of where things are going to go. This is not a very precise drawing. Encourage you to do a better job than me. Actually try. Okay. Is that Arkansas? Kinda. Should probably be a little shorter. But you know what? I don't care. I'm gonna leave it, okay? I mean, I do care, but I want it to get most of this painting in here. I guess I could make it shorter, but I'm gonna cut off some of the sky and some of the bottom. I'm gonna leave it, okay? Okay, so anyway, so I see where my outline is. All right, I should probably stop moving my mic. Okay. But let's put some clouds in here. Okay, so let's start with one here. Let's just draw a straight line right there. Okay, and then on the end, I'm going to make it kind of taper up. And then on the top, I'll start making some little bumps. Okay, fluff it up. Okay. All right, fluffers, fluff up your clouds. All right, let's put one in here. Also, it's a good area to, like, there's a spot you want to cover up. Honestly, it's a good, kind of a good thing for that. You can kind of go, I don't like this area. Boink. Big old cloud. Should probably make it a little more. I don't know, make it a little different. Okay, so there's two clouds. Let's see. I think I'm going to put one more here. And probably just one little one going in there. Okay, and there's my four clouds. You know, actually, I want one that's actually in the middle here. So let's go ahead and put one right here. Kind of a little nothing going on area. There we go. There's my four clouds. Okay, what I want to do here is I'm going to start with white paint. I'm going to fill them in all white. Have a lot of thick white paint. And then while it's wet, I'll take some yellow and then some purple and mix in some shadows and highlights on there. And yeah, it'll be good. It'll be what's going to work. This is going to work. Okay, this is going to work. Let's wash our brushes out. I'm going to take my medium flat brush, wash it out real good. When you have a cat and a dog, there's hair is just getting everything. Oh, it's complaining while painting with Joel F. Ward. If anyone can guess, it's gonna drive me crazy. Okay, anyway. Yeah, let's take some white paint here and paint these in. Let's just paint these in. Alright, take your white paint. There we go. Okay, so I'm just gonna start filling these in. Okay, I'm using lots of thick paint. Get them real nice and solid. Thick paint. And then, you know, I know it's going to go up here, but I know that's where the edge of my state shape is, so I don't have to really... Well, I need to go outside that if I don't want to. I'm going to drop this cloud down a little bit. Lady, yeah. Sorry. Okay, so there's two. So I'm just gonna keep going here, fill all these in. And then while they're wet, I'll take a little bit of light yellow, put the yellow on the bottoms of the clouds because that sun is setting. So it's kind of like that's where the light's hitting it. Then I'll take the purple and put that on the top because that would be more of the shaded area. And that's how I'm gonna do clouds. Okay, that's clouds. All right. If you need more instruction than that, I'll probably go over it again, but you know, just let it go. It's a cloud, okay? If someone looks at your cloud and goes, that's not how a cloud looks, just say, you need to get out of my house right now. Because that's a dumb, shitty person who's just a judgmental asshole. Who's gonna tell you what a cloud looks like, huh? It's a cloud. Is it kind of lightish or grayish? It's a cloud. You can say anything, whatever. Anyway, sorry, I'm getting off on a tangent here about clouds. Okay, here we go. Get some yellow. You know what I've... I watch too much TV, obviously. Okay, let's take some yellow and kind of start by streaking that in here. Boom. Ooh, yellow. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of brush that in here a little bit, let it blend. Now, you got to make sure your white paint's still wet when you do this, but just take some... yellow, blend that in a little bit on the bottom. You know what I hate though is just really terrible unoriginal jingles that totally work and get stuck in your head, like Liberty, Liberty, Liberty. Like, how did they? What should we use for our jingle? For Liberty, maybe Liberty, 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 Liberty. Brilliant. There's an old Jim Gaffigan bit about Hot Pockets. It's the same deal. Like, there's just so many jingles that are just like... so... just basic. That's a basic. Okay, there we go. Got the yellow. Let's take some purple. Very, very light purple. Let's take some purple and some white. Okay, very light purple. So lots of white, a little bit of purple. And let's take that, brush that into the tops. So I'm going to kind of outline the top. And that doesn't even look purple. Okay. I think I got some other colors in my paint, but... There we go. A little bit of purple in there. And my paint is starting to dry, it looks like. So it's not mixing terrifically. It's mixing a little bit, but... Gotta kind of move fast through this. And then, you know, I want to kind of mix it a little bit, you know, with those yellow... I don't want to be like a hard edge between the yellow and the purple. So if it's still a little wet, mix it. If you need to grab some more white to kind of be a little bit of a... What's the word? Catalyst? No. Something like that. You need something. I'm gonna kind of go in between. You can use some more white. But there you go. There's some clouds. A little bit of yellow on the bottoms coming up. There's a little bit of purple on the top. So I'm showing some shadow. Okay, sky. Pretty much done. Let's take a shot. And by pretty much done, I mean completely done. I can go back and add stuff if I want, but I'm not going to. Okay, shot. Cheers. So hot in this room. Ugh, and this whiskey's hot, and so is the Dr. Pepper. It's okay, though. It's gonna be okay. Okay, today's trivia question, if you want to win a free painting, is... what is Arkansas's main export? Okay, is it A, tobacco? Is it? Is it B, Clinton's? Which has already been guessed, so Clinton's off the table. C, squirrels. D, Arkansas doesn't export anything. E, tornadoes. F, moonshine. G, sadness. Or H, books. Okay? In the honor of Arkansas. So hot. Oh! Okay, we'll start down here in a minute and do some water, but I'm not ready yet. Did I count that shot? I don't think I did. Did I? I don't think I did. Also, today is... National Megalodon Day. Does anybody know what a megalodon is? Okay, we got a guess for moonshine. Off the top of your heads, what do you think a megalodon is? Because I thought I knew what it was. Cheers. So today is National Megalodon Day, which I thought was like a dinosaur or something. It's a shark. It's just a shark. I looked at a picture and it just looks like a basic ass shark. So that's what today's National Megalodon Day. Is it Shark Week right now? Because you would think that would be during Shark Week, right? You think maybe Shark Week's based on that. Where does Shark Week come from? Who started that? Well, this is just a show where I ask you questions. But it is also National Smile Power Day. What are the... That's stupid. But it's also National Nature Photography Day. Okay. This is a funny picture of nature photography. I like that picture. Oh, there it is again. Oh, whoops. Wait, where'd it go? Oh, whoops. Oh. Peekaboo. Peekabooty. 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 What's peekabooty? Peekabooty. That's where... Okay, I'm gonna get some yellow and white on my brush. Peekabooty. That's where, you go into the... Go to get a physical or prostate exam. Peekabooty is where you go to get a prostate exam and the doctor has to stick his finger up your butt. And he's like, where's my butthole? I don't know. Peekabooty. Oh, where'd he go? Sorry. I said peekabooty and I couldn't not. Okay. All right, shut up, Joel. Okay. All right, here we go. Let's take some light yellow. Let's go left and right. I'm going to take my brush on that skinny side there. And just go left and right. Okay, make some little streakies like that. Now we're going to start actually painting this water. So first we've kind of been getting it kind of blocked in, the big colors. And then we're just going to take this color down here. Peek-a-booty. I'm such an idiot. Okay. Why is it making me laugh so much? Okay, yellow, let's take some orange. So I'm just gonna cycle through my colors and put some little streaks of color. I'm gonna start with my warm colors so that if they do mix, you know, yellow and orange will mix fine, orange and red will mix fine, blah, 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 right? So here we go, I've got some of that. Let's take some of this orange. And basically right here along this line, that's where I'm gonna start. Kind of putting some of this in there. If I let any color go through the middle, it's gonna be this orange because it's closest to the yellow. And my paint is very thick and making very thick texture, which I don't know. I think I just need to get a new plate, honestly. I'm done with this plate. Eventually, the only downside to like using paper plates is sometimes, even with this stuff that's got the, what's it called? The wax, I think it's the wax layer. It will still eventually dry out and start absorbing some of your paint, like moisture. So you, I don't know, after a while it does start to just kind of get dried out again. And that's really just, eventually your plate draws some of that. That's why a lot of painters, when they use palette, they use glass. Because glass won't really absorb much of the moisture out of the paint. Okay, let's take a little bit of red. Let's make up some more orange here. Peek-a-booty. Where'd it go? Where'd it go? Okay. Okay. Let's, keep painting. Water, water, water. I think maybe the texture, maybe the texture of my painting at this point. So I've added enough layers maybe that it's just gotten thicker. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of mess up a lot of the yellow, because then I'm going to go through later and put yellow back on top. So it's kind of a lot of layering up here. I kind of dip my brush in paint almost every single brush stroke because it's just not coming out very smooth. Okay, so if that happens, you just gotta, it's just kind of what you have to do. It's tedious. That's what you have to do. You just gotta keep dipping it in that paint, get lots of thick paint on your brush. Okay, now let's get some red paint. So what I'm finding is there's certain areas of my painting that are thick. It's because I tried to have that, it's got a rougher texture right there. I think once I layer it up, it might, maybe it'll be better, I don't know, but maybe it's because there's still some of that texture from the canvas from the beginning, and I'm still using kind of thin paint right here, and you're still kind of getting some of that texture a little bit more. Maybe that's what it is, I don't know. I'll be honest with you, I don't fucking know. They can't catch me. But yeah, you know, I've been watching Boba Fett, that show, and I do not like it as much as Mandalorian. I don't know what it is. Well, I'll tell you this, okay. Okay, if anybody's watched Boba Fett, I think it might be episode 3 or 4, 2, 3, or 4, somewhere in there. There is the lamest ever chase scene I've ever seen in my life. I mean, it's like the speeder chase scene. And I mean, I kind of don't ever want to watch Star Wars ever again in my life, because that was the dumbest thing I've maybe ever seen. I mean, in a Star Wars movie, it definitely is. That was ridiculous. Like, I don't know who... I don't know how that got through to, like, being on the screen, to being like, this is... Who watched that scene and thought this is cool? Like, oh yeah, this is where it's passable. It's not. It's one of the worst things I've ever seen. Like, that speeder chase scene was like a joke. It was like, it's like if you film two kids with like holding on to like little toy cars and running them around a little track. It was horrific. It was so bad. I kind of couldn't believe what was happening. I was kind of like, is this a joke? Like, is it supposed to be horrible? Horrible. But I do love The Mandalorian, and I decided if I have a daughter, I'm going to name her middle name probably Lori Ann, and her first name Mandy. So she's... Oh, why did I pour that in my shot glass? So she's Mandy Lori Ann. So she's Mandalorian, you know? That'd be a good name for a daughter. Mandy Lori Ann. Mandalorian. So yeah, just name your daughter Mandy, and then Lori Ann for the middle name, and it's Mandalorian. Well, I hope Star Wars nerds do that. That'd be funny. Okay. We've got purple. Big deal. Okay, let's get green. Why not? Shit. Yeah, farts. Okay, you know, let's take some blue. Let's take a little yeller. Let's make some green, okay? Let's make some green. Maybe a little white. Take our medium flat brush here. Make sure we get it cleaned out. And, yeah. Mandy Lorian. It's a good name if you're a Star Wars nerd. Mandalorian. I think it's a good idea. If I was a Star Wars nerd, I would name my daughter Mandy Lorian. Okay, a little bit of white here too, so it stands out. You want a little bit of white, and I might actually mix a little bit more blue in here with it. Oh, that might be a little too much. When you're mixing blue and yellow, blue's always way stronger. You always need a lot more yellow than blue just to get the color right. Okay, but I do want just a little bit more white now. There we go. And let's take some of this in here. Now, my red was the last color I used. It might still be a little wet. I might try to be a little careful of that, but honestly, it dries fast enough that not really, and I'm using thin paint, so it shouldn't be too big of a deal, really. Okay, there we go. Liberty, liberty, liberty. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Okay, greens. It's very Christmas right now. Wow. Okay, now we'll do blue and white, so make some more light blues. That'll be nice in the water. The light blues we can kind of make a little bit more kind of just spread out throughout my... throughout the water. Go and get some new white, because I don't want to mix that in, that green in with my blue. I want to have nice, just nice, pretty blue. So that's what we'll do. Peek-a-booty. Oh, God, it's so stupid. What's wrong with me? What's wrong with me? Okay, white and blue. Let's go. Oh, yeah. Look at that blue. It's probably too light, honestly. Find a good blue color. If you like this blue, that's a good blue. I'll take that and I'll start streaking that in here, mainly towards the outside edges. Start in over here. Okay, but you know what? This blue, I can kind of put wherever. I'm going to just start going crazy with it, okay? Just go crazy. So the blue and the yellow, you want to kind of like really... let really take over a lot of these areas. I'm getting really sick of this rough texture, though. Why is that happening so much? It's not just water in the paint, it's thick texture on the canvas. I need to just press down harder. It's a lot better when you just kind of sling it. Okay, and why is it all tilting down? Am I... maybe that's why. Is that why? It's not really tilting down that much. I think it's all angled over because of the canvas. Why does it look so angled down? I mean, that's really flat. Tune in to watch me not know what I'm doing. I does what I like and I like what I do. I does what I like
and I like. Thank you, most interesting. I does what I like and I like what I do. I does what I like and I like.
Likes and I likes what I do. He does what I likes and I likes. I does what I likes and I likes what I do. Does what I likes and I likes. Okay. You know, that's something. That's something. Probably. Take a shot and come back to it, okay? Hey, what's up, Winter King? How you doing? By the way, I don't know if Lugdor or C. Purdy is watching, but I mailed Purdy a shot glass and Lugdor, I mailed your painting. I don't know what to do, but I guess I'll take a shot. I feel like I haven't been counting my shots today. Don't be sorry. It's not your fault or anything. I tried. I actually, you know, it's kind of cool to try to send something that far. Hey, you want to win another painting? I'll try again. All right. Old Winter King, I am in the state of Arkansas, and this is the Arkansas shape here. So in that theme, the trivia question today is, what is Arkansas's main export? Okay, is it tobacco? Is it the Clintons? Is it squirrels? Is it Arkansas doesn't export anything? Is it tornadoes, moonshine, sadness, or books? All right, that's the trivia question. Don't look it up. Don't cheat and look it up. Give it a guess, I'll send you another painting. Oh. It's also National Nature Photography Day. Okay, so there you go. A little nature photography for you. And I think what I'm going to do now is, I think I'm going to go ahead and start painting in the trees and stuff out here, okay? So let's go ahead and take, I'm going to take my chalk. Okay, and let's really draw a straight line here, because I'm all concerned about straight lines. And let's go ahead and go like this. Let's make our little, let me just use blue. Probably show up better. Nothing worth importing. I'm gonna say that counts as they don't export anything. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just kind of draw a little vague line for kind of where this tree line is, right? There's a little tree line. But I'm going to mirror that on the bottom as well, okay? There we go, something like that. Okay. Okay, same thing over here. Some kind of tree line. Mirror it on the bottom. Okay. Now let's take our black paint. Now I'm going to take my medium round brush here. Where is it? There it is. Take that brush out, tap it off. Let's take our medium round brush. Get some black paint and start painting that in. Oh man, did anybody else love the Muppets? I think I do. Anybody else watch like the Muppet Show in there, kids? Maybe. Hey, Old Winter King, did you have any Muppets or any? Do you have any Sesame Street over there? What did you grow up watching as a kid? Australia. Wait, that's how do you do an Australian accent? Oh, you do? You have both? Oh, cool. Winter King, do you want to hear my Australian accent? I'm not gonna do it unless he wants it. Okay, so basically I'm just gonna take this and I'm just gonna kind of like squiggle back and forth a little wider at the bottom. If you see little spots showing through, that's a good thing. Okay, you see some little, you know, light peek-a-booty and through peek-a-booty. Oh my god. Okay, I think when I think of peek-a-booty, I think of butt cheeks. And open it, spreading your butt cheeks, and there's a butthole, and it's like peek-a-booty. And I don't know why, now that I said peek-a-booty, I can't get it out of my head. Somebody at work the other day said peek-a-booty. And hadn't really thought about it till just now. Alright, yeah, cool, send it to me. Peek-a-booty. Sorry. Okay. Okay, so again, down here, I'm going to start trying to mirror this. So I'm just going to basically do the same thing I did there in reverse. Start squiggling, but squiggling from the... So I started up here and kind of squiggled down. I'm going to start down here at the bottom and squiggle up. Now, I'm not done with the water. This is just kind of the first layer. Or this is probably the second or third layer, I guess. I don't know why I said first. But I'm gonna go back and add some more to the water to like get it right. It's not done yet. Okay, we see that's mirrored there, so it's the same on the top and the bottom. All right, let's go here. Keep adding that water. Yeah, and what else going on? Oh, hockey finals. I know NBA playoffs are going on right now. And yeah, I watch these like NBA highlights on YouTube, and it's like, watch these fake outs, and they get more epic every time, and they don't get more epic. Kind of makes me mad. I'm just like, what did I so? Just clickbait, and I fell for it. I think that's why I'm mad, is because I fell for it, you know. But, I mean, come on. Those things are liars. Like, watch this fake out. And it's like, he does this and then shoots. And it's like, okay. Yeah, he fake passed. He kind of did a fake pass there. Makes me mad. Why does it make me mad? You know, what does this say about me as a person? What does it say about me? that I get mad about things like this. Okay, there we go. There's some... Look at that. We've got, you know... tree line. Let's blow dry this, and we'll keep messing with our water. We're not done yet. It's not quite right. Now, if I angle my painting where it's just right... Okay, that is pretty flat. It is angling down a little bit in here. I mean, this would be flat. Right? And it's going to angle just barely. Just barely enough. Oh, cool. I'm offline now. Sweet. My shit's not even getting out there. But you know what? I don't care. I'm still going to take a shot. So, anyway. Peek-a-booty. Oh, they say I'm still on. Okay. Okay, let's, paint some more stuff. Let's just do this whole thing again, you know? Still looks like crap, so I need to fix it. Oh, shit. Oh, no, I spilled all that black on my table. Oh, jeez. Hold on, everybody. Everybody just hold on. Ugh. Mom, what are you doing right now? Shouldn't you be like fixing dinner or something? What are you doing right? I guess you've got till 5:30, huh? How was work today, Mom? I was at the post office today. Okay, what should I do here? Take my medium flat brush, wash it out. Hey Mom, did Lacey send you those pictures of the shot glasses? I'm just gonna use this to talk to my mom. Did she send you those pictures? Mother, are you listening? Excuse me, Mother? You have a roast in the cockpot? You got a roast in the cockpot? Roast in the crockpot? That sounds pretty good. Wish I had a roast in the cockpot. I think I'm probably gonna make a chicken quesadilla though tonight. I ate tacos last night. Or maybe, I might see a turkey sandwich. I don't know. So how are the pictures though? Were they good enough for you? Good enough for you, Mom? Because I don't know. I saw some of them and I thought it could be better. Ooh, see that? Ooh, see that? We're taking some of this yellow. Ooh, now it's starting. Yellow's starting to pop. I mainly want to keep this yellow through the middle. Let's let some of these, you know, let's let some of these colors just dance, okay? Let them just dance. Let them just dance in there. Let them, you know, kind of just. You know, go back and forth, let them overlap. But I do want to take the yellow down to the middle and some main areas there. You know, a lot of these areas where it's starting to get kind of congested there. Put some of that thick, light yellow paint there. Okay, it really brightens up that middle. Try to keep it balanced on both sides, you know, a little bit. Got a little bit going on over here, put a little bit over here, you know, kind of try to keep her balanced there. Is my mic? I feel like I keep moving my mic. And I said I feel like I'm doing that because I completely am doing it. Okay, so there's yellow. Okay. All right, now time for some orange. Actually, I think I'm gonna, let's put a little bit more orange in there. Let's just put a little bit more of our color in there in general. Rock and roll something or other. Oh, whoa. Mom, are you proud of me? I didn't work today. Well, I wasn't supposed to work, but someone asked me to come in, and I'm like, you guys got it. This is what I'm doing with my life today, Mom. Be honest. Okay, I got the orange. Let's put a little bit more red. I don't know how I made this painting look the way it did the first time. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I'm kind of just trying to figure it out. My mom's not answering, which makes me think she's not proud of me. Okay, there's some red. Maybe a little red there. A red there. Rolled down. You know, I'm not a big fan of the red. Not a big fan of the red. Let's take a little green. Maybe the green's gonna be better. I think the green will be better. I like the green better. And there's really no green in this painting, but for some reason it looks cool in the water, so I'm just gonna do what looks cool. My mom says, I'm very proud of you. Your dad called me just now. Oh, okay. Are you saying... Oh, Dad called you, so that's why you couldn't respond immediately. Is that maybe what you're saying? Nice cover, Mom. Okay, let's do a little bit more blue. This is going to be the last layer of colors in the water. Okay, I promise. I promise. I promise. Oh, Mom says yes, okay. All right, blue, here we go. Blue, let's really take this in from the outside edges especially. Okay, now it's starting to look a little bit better. Okay, that's looking a little bit nicer. Okay, all right, okay, we finally got it. Okay, let's dry it. We'll put a little black, a little white in the water, and then it'll be done. Then we'll do the outside edge, and it'll be done, okay? So, with that be, with the, you know, somebody got mad at me for saying, if someone else says, if that being said one more time, I'm gonna freak out. So it's like, what am I supposed to do? With that being said, so instead what am I supposed to say? So that happened, and next. What are you supposed to say instead of that being said? I don't know. But I'm gonna take a shot. My mom says she likes the colors. Well, thanks, Mom. I love you. I love you, Mom. Cheers to my mom. You know, she said I like all these colors, not I love all these colors. I kind of projected. Mom, what's a commercial jingle that annoys you? Or what's one that you love? Medium flat brush, ladies and gentlemen. A little bit of black. We're gonna basically do the same thing there we did earlier, but a little bit more, spread out. There we go. Just tiny little bits of black in there, okay? Tiny little bits of black in there, like sitcoms in the 90s. Like Friends in the 90s. Is that okay? I like to kind of measure down. Okay, that's about the height there. I can kind of plate that a little bit. This seems a little, maybe a really dark. Fill in some of these, you know. Okay. It's kind of good if you go back and forth. Oh, come on, Mom. What's a good jingle? What's a jingle that annoys you or that you love? What's a jingle that's the first dumb TV jingle that pops in your head, huh? Okay, there we go. That's starting to look good. So you can kind of still see some of these colors through there. So it's kind of nice. One that's around here goes, you don't have to put up with any malarkey call, blah, 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 blah. Here's Sparky. And it's for Sparkies. Yeah, Liberty. Exactly. Liberty, Liberty, Liberty. It's like, it's kind of like brainwashing. Pretty pink, pretty pink. Okay, I think we're okay. Last thing we gotta do, white paint. Wash your medium flat brush out real good. Let's take a shot. Okay, trivia question. Trivia question. Oh, that's John Mayer. That's pretty funny though. Trivia question. There we go. What's Arkansas's main export? If you guess this correctly, I'll send you a free painting. There's the answer. There's the things. Okay. Here we go. Take your little flat brush and wash it out. And we're gonna use some white paint. Hey, you know, I haven't been drinking as much this week. I drank last Wednesday, and then I drank one night, not heavily, but I drank a little bit. Then I drank like one other night, like a little tiny bit. I don't really drink other than that. Me and Lacey, our neighbors, left a couch out, and they moved, so they just left some free stuff, and we're like, hey. Like, they left, they asked if we wanted it, and Lacey said, yeah, because we put it in our room in here. Well, it didn't actually fit into the bedroom, like, in this room in here. But we did fuck up our wall pretty good trying to get it in. Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous, though. My friend Alex was over. Well, he was gonna come over anyway, and then I come home, and I see his couch in our garage, and they had moved out that day, and... I forgot where I was going with this. I come home and there's a couch, so my friend Alex comes over, my best friend Alex, and so we're hanging out and drinking, and then I'm like, fuck, you know, before you leave, we should probably try to move this couch in here while we got you here. And he doesn't care. He said, yeah. I mean, I feel bad. I'm kind of like, you know, you don't have to. But he's such a nice guy. He helps me move. So we get the couch inside. We move the couch in here that's in this room out. And it's a littler... It's not a crazy couch, but it's still a bitch just to move anything. And then we get the big couch in here, and we're trying to move it in. I mean, we had to have tried for an hour and a half, and At one point, the couch is lodged like midair, like tilted this crazy angle between the door and the walls. And it's like, I mean, try somebody, and whenever I'd have to come, I'd be like, oh, let me come out there to your side. And I'd have to like squeeze and crawl underneath this couch in the doorway to get out. But yeah, we had this big couch jammed between the doorway and the wall that comes in after the door, like where the closet is. And it was hanging there in midair for like, I mean, if we let go, that's just where it hung. It was pretty awesome. But I'm literally like still sore from it. Anyway, that night I got really drunk. Then I kept drinking because I was like, well, you know, help me. Okay, I'm gonna take some white paint and start streaking this through my water. But yeah, I just thought, you know, ooh, that looks cool, putting it through the... That's a little too much there, but for the most part, I like this. Maybe some very, very light... Ooh, that's a little too much, but that's okay. Maybe some very light brush strokes. Through the middle, you can kind of be a little more heavy-handed there. I don't know. Point is, we didn't get the couch in, so then we had to take it out and put the old couch back in. And, you know, so that was pretty defeating, I guess. But you know what? It was a good night. I did get drunk, though. But that was one of the few nights I got drunk. Okay, let's take our big brush out of our water cup and get black paint and paint in our outside area. And then we'll paint the edges black. And we'll paint the edge off. Quote, hashtag copyright paint the edge off. Copyright paint the edge off. We're going to hashtag copyright paint the edge off. Copyright trademark paint the edge off. And let's go ahead and paint this in. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and go around the edges first. Let's get this nice and solid. You know what's really obnoxious is when people do British accents. Except for when you and your girlfriend do it all the time and then it's fun. But then when other people do it, you're like, I hate you. This is stupid. Please don't ever do this again. But then at home, me and Lacey do it all the time. It's really stupid, and I know it's stupid, but I can't help it. But I try really hard not to do accents on live when I'm streaming because I know how stupid they are. I know how angry I would be if I were you and I started doing a dumb fucking accent. Okay, I'm gonna start drawing in kind of that outside. That line that we drew to kind of show where that arc inside, or whatever shape you're doing, you know, start tracing that in. Oh crap, there's a little notch right here. Okay. Forgot about the notch. Okay, there we go. There's that notch. You know, this is stylized Arkansas, okay? Tell them how I feel. Leave it like that. Okay, here we go. Here's your problem. At the end of these, I'm hammered. And this is when I gotta do these fine details and make things look correct. And that's when I really fuck everything up. So I'm Here we go. I'm gonna
block it out.
Here we go.
It's just like whenever you get pulled over drunk and you got to do a sobriety test and you're wasting. You're like, all right, Joel, come on, now's the time. Lock it out. Lock it out, man. Just pass this sobriety test. Not that that's ever happened, Mom, but if it did happen, that's what I would do. It's not like that's happened to me like 7 or 8 times. In my younger days, that doesn't happen anymore. Okay. That's the only real solace you can take in that, is that did happen a lot in my 20s, but doesn't happen anymore. Okay, because now I Uber, or I just sleep on the sidewalk. Now what I do is I just pass out in a trash can. And no driving for me. I've just gotten very comfortable sleeping in alleyways. Okay, but I don't drive. Okay, I don't drive. I just sleep on sidewalks, fire escapes. Anyone's just an open car that's sitting in someone's driveway, I'll sleep in that. Gardens are really comfortable to sleep in. I sleep in those when I'm drunk sometimes and I don't want to drive home. Because I'm going to get a... Oh my god, what happened to my... How did I get this white paint on my fingers? When I'm hammered, instead of... I don't get DUIs anymore, okay? Because instead of that... Instead of driving home drunk, what I do is I just... I fall asleep in someone's garden. Or an alleyway. I fall asleep in... Or I just hang out for like 6 hours. Outside someone's window, just watch what they're watching with no sound. Hopefully if I find somebody who has subtitles on and I just watch what they're watching and I'm like, this is nice, and I sober up, maybe take a little nap in the bushes and then wake up and go, okay, I'm good to drive now, and I drive home, and that's how I stay out of trouble. Okay, we're not done yet. Last thing we gotta do is take purple and white. That's not purple, that's blue. Let's take purple and white here. Oh shit, that's a lot. Let's take our medium flat brush. Yeah, that one. Let's get purple and white. Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. Let's put a little accent line. Oh! Little accent line going around there. Hopefully, maybe you did a different state. If you don't live in Arkansas, you know, I mean, unless you just really like, oh, I like the, it's ironic. Hopefully you did a different symbol, maybe something that means something to you. Not that Arkansas means anything to me, I just fucking live here. Hey, you know what, Fayetteville's cool though, I don't care what anybody says, Fayetteville's pretty nice. I mean, the whole world's going down the shitter, but, you know, Fayetteville's still cool. For now. Okay, let's sign our painting. Hey, look at that. We signed our painting. Let's paint that bottom edge. And, who's the winner today? The winner today is... Well, hold on. I gotta paint the bottom edge and then I'll go over who won. Okay, well, we did it. Congratulations, everybody. We painted the Arkansas sunset. Look at that. Well, that's a neat little painting, and I hope y'all enjoyed that. Maybe you didn't, though. Maybe you hated this, and I'm sorry. But hopefully you enjoyed. If you painted along with me, hopefully I helped you paint a little bit. Stupid plates. So today's trivia question was, what's Arkansas's main export? Tobacco? No. Is it the Clintons? Probably. There's a lot of them. And that's a kind of the two Clintons. Just those two. Plus the kid. You know, that accounts for a lot. Squirrels? There's a lot of squirrels on campus, but I hear that that's common with every college campus, so I don't think that's right. Arkansas doesn't export anything. They do export, okay? Export a lot. Tornadoes? No. Okay, a common misconception. Tornadoes are just kind of in a belt. They aren't made in manufacturing or exported. F, moonshine? No one guessed moonshine, okay, which was a close second. No one actually guessed that. G, sadness? No. Very happy people here. Well, actually, I don't know. But, you know, sadness, not so great. There's not so bad. I mean, it's not that bad. Books? Definitely not. There's some writers here, but books aren't. No, you didn't, Mom. You didn't guess. Did you guess moonshine? You did guess moonshine. Okay, so the winners today, okay, now this is real. This is completely real. I'm going to tell you the actual real, Arkansas's main export is aircraft, aircrafts, aircraft engines, military aircraft. Who knew, right? And then it was like wheat or something like that. I don't know. Who cares? But the real answer is Clintons and moonshine and whatever old Winter King guessed. He says nothing. So I'm going to say D. So all three of you win, okay? Because I, whatever, you guys all win. And, so that's the answer to the trivia question. And you know what? I love you guys. Thanks for getting drunk and painting with me, and I really hope that you guys have a good time, and maybe someday you'll come to Arkansas and export something, you know? Okay, bye. I love you.